So there's a different toilet in the RV.
Oh, you noticed?
Yeah.
Hey everyone, it's James.
And Stephanie.
Now, we will often talk smack on cassette toilets on our website.
Well, I'm mostly worried about the capacity and that it would be constant maintenance and dumping it.
Yeah, and I am not at all looking forward to having to dump one and get that close and personal.
Yeah.
But we've always talked that way, having never used one.
Right, but apparently that's changing on this trip.
Yeah, so I've installed temporarily a cassette toilet in our RV, Lance.
And the good thing is we're only going on a 3-day trip right now, so it's a low commitment test we're about to do.
A little hike and bike journey, and I've installed it temporarily so I can completely remove it when we're done.
Good. So we don't know how this is going to go.
We have no idea, but we're going to use it for the weekend, and then we'll tell you what we think of it.
All right, fingers crossed.
All right. So here's our test subject. This is a Thetford Curve. It's got a 4.5-gallon fresh water reservoir and a 5.5-gallon waste water reservoir. I've just sort of mounted it temporarily on that board so that if we don't like it, I can just pull it right out when we're done. So I guess we need to read the instructions, and then we'll be off to the races. And we're back.
Yes, we are. And we had a great trip, didn't we?
We did. Steph completed her first century of the year.
100 miles.
And we definitely came back with some things to say about the cassette toilet.
Oh, yes. But it started off really great, didn't
it? Yeah, yeah. We were loving it for a while, and then we hit the one fatal flaw. We'll get to that.
Yeah. Let's compare it first to our composting toilet so you guys can kind of see the differences.
Right. So some of the reasons we got the composting toilet also apply to the cassette. Like, it would be good for winter camping.
Yeah, and that's why we got the composting toilet in the first place. If you saw our video about that, you know that's super important for us.
Right. There's no there's no plumbing running to it, so there's nothing to freeze, and there's no waste tank on the outside of the RV, so the cassette toilet would work just as well there.
Mm-hmm.
The other thing is it doesn't use any water. Well, not exactly true. It does use water, but it's from its own internal reservoir.
Right, so it's not using from your tanks, so.
Right.
Yeah.
And then I guess the other thing is if you were looking to build one into your RV, the cassette toilet install is even easier than a composting toilet.
Well, you don't even have to install it. You could just carry it in and plop it down and it's ready to go.
Yeah. So that for those reasons, we were seriously considering the cassette toilet instead of our composting toilet.
Emphasis on were. All right, so let's start by addressing some questions we think people might have about the cassette toilet.
And chief among these, I think, is going to be smell.
Yeah.
Did it smell? Now, I detected no smell from the cassette toilet when the trap door was closed.
I think you should think about it like your home toilet. It's going to smell in the same way as your home toilet would smell when you use it.
It was right when you use it. And in this case, I would kind of give the nod to the composting toilet because it's got that fan that's always pulling air out, even right when you're using it.
Right. It's pretty amazing on the composting toilet how it never smells. So,
but again, I wouldn't call the smells a problem with the cassette toilet at all.
All right, other questions.
Can you use the toilet standing up? I had no issues using the toilet standing up.
I had no issues either.
Nice.
I guess this is a guy issue.
So the bowl in our cassette toilet was quite a bit deeper than the composting toilet. And so we didn't have any splatter. I didn't have any splatter, any issues like that. For all I know, you didn't either.
No splatter issues.
Okay. Now, there was one weird little quirk.
Oh, yeah, the burp.
The burping. So, since the cassette toilet doesn't have a vent, and there's a sealed container of the wastewater there, if it gets warmer, then pressure can build up in that. And so, when you open the trap door, if there's liquid in it, it can burp back up at you.
Yeah. So, you get splashed, which is kind of gross.
Unpleasant.
But you just got to remember to do this burping technique, which is the name James gave it.
You burp the toilet before you use it, and that releases that pressure ahead of time. You'll only forget once, and then after that, you really won't ever forget again.
So burping is basically just opening and closing that little trap door in there.
Yeah. And bugs, did we have any issue? I don't even see how we could have an issue with bugs.
No, is that even an issue? Does that come up?
I don't know.
Cassette toilets? I know it does with composting toilets.
Yeah, if you got bugs in your cassette toilet, you'd be doing something seriously wrong.
Yeah.
So we didn't have that issue at all.
So thumbs up for that.
All right. Okay, so the next thing I want to talk about with the cassette toilet is moisture management. Now, we spent a lot of time with the composting toilet talking about this in that video.
Yeah.
And a lot of the things that were an issue there were not an issue at all with the cassette toilet. Like, you can use it where there's high humidity. It's great. We showered with the thing right in the bathroom.
And
no
if you
problems.
Saw our composting toilet video, you know there was an issue with separating the liquids and the solids because you're trying to keep that compost really dry. You don't have that issue in this toilet. You can just go.
Just let her rip. You know, if you got the stomach flu, that would be no issue with a cassette toilet.
If you got liquid coming out either end, no problem.
Anyway, with a composting toilet, if you get the stomach flu, you'd basically have to go find yourself a hotel room or something.
Yeah.
But not an issue with the cassette. So use it just like your home toilet in those respects.
And then cleaning.
Cleaning
is the next thing.
A lot easier with the cassette toilet.
Well, sure, because there's some water. You're adding water to the bowl.
Right, so. And you can use whatever product you want to clean it. It's not like a composting toilet where you'd have to worry about getting bleach or cleaner in there and killing off the bacteria. Heck no, just dump it in there.
Right. And if you saw my composting toilet video where we talked about heavy flow days,
la,
ladies,
la, 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 la.
With a composting toilet, that's a problem because it's a dry bowl. But in a cassette toilet, no problem. You've got water just like a normal toilet.
So
non-issue.
Moisture management, definite plus in the column for the cassette toilet. Kicked butt over the composting toilet in that one.
And cleaning as well.
Yep. Okay, so the big concern we had with the cassette toilet going in was capacity.
Well, and that's because we're dumping the liquids tank on our composting toilet every day. So we knew we were taking up a ton of capacity already with the composting toilet.
With just liquids.
So we expected that to be a problem with the cassette toilet.
But remarkably, it wasn't. We were in the rig for almost 3 days.
Right.
And we only got halfway into the red zone.
Yeah, now we weren't in the rig all 3 days. We were out doing stuff and using other toilets.
Right, but we were acting in all respects as we normally do on an RV trip.
That's normal for us.
We were both using it, you know, when we were there, and we didn't have to give it any breaks.
Yeah.
Like we do with the composting toilet, and we didn't have to empty it once while we were out on the road over 3 days.
So we were pretty impressed with the capacity and surprised.
Pleasantly surprised. In fact, at this point, like we're returning home from our trip, we were pretty much all thumbs up on the cassette toilet.
You were making plans to rip out the composting toilet, take the fan out.
Yeah. We had all sorts of plans on how we were going to change our RVing, and then.
It stinks so bad, I don't want to get any closer.
Don't. Okay, that's considerably worse than a composting toilet. Really not good. Stop. Absolutely. That was so awful.
Oh my God, you guys, it was so bad. The smell was vile.
It was terrible. So we've had, just so you know where we're coming from, we've had years of experience with a regular RV toilet.
Yes.
And coming up on 2 years with a composting toilet.
Yes.
And they've all malfunctioned, so we know what we're talking about when we get bad smells, and they were nothing like this.
No, this smells, I can't even describe to you. I still am traumatized.
We ate our dinners out here on the deck for like 3 or 4 days.
We hired maids to come and clean our bathroom the next day. I'm not kidding you.
It was very, and I was following the directions. It said, just empty it into a toilet. So I said, okay, sure. Yeah, no, in an enclosed space, never do that.
And I wasn't even in the bathroom. I was outside the bathroom holding a video camera, and I was still gagging.
There were candles. The cat ran away. It was so bad. The cat was like, dude, I've got a box, and it's better than... It was so bad.
Guys, it was bad.
I immediately pulled out the mounting for the cassette toilet and repatriated the composting toilet back to our RV. It was so much better.
But you gotta know this too. You have to dump it more than once. I mean, you had to go back and fill it up with water to get all the solids out.
I'm dumping it.
It was eight dumps.
There's still chunks.
I had
There's
tears
still chunks
in my eyes.
It was really, really bad. And it was so bad that one thing alone was enough to negate any other benefits the cassette toilet had.
Oh my gosh, I just thought of something.
What?
We're going to Germany in 2 months.
That's all they have over there. Yay.
We just won't.
We'll cancel our trip. It was really, really...
we're not exaggerating any. It was just that bad. Just
we will never, ever own a cassette toilet in an RV. I'm saying that now.
So in the composting toilet versus cassette toilet smackdown, the knockout punch, kind of literally.
Bye-bye, cassette toilet. The compost is back in.
And it's going to stay there. I think that's going to about do it for us. I'm having PTSD now. You couldn't empty this thing in a regular public restroom. You'd be accused of an act of domestic terrorism. It would be that bad.
Absolutely.
So we're going to sign off before I start having nightmares again. That's all for now.
Thanks for watching.
Bye.